2000s, perhaps late 90s, which eventually culminated in the Enforce and Protect Act. But what was happening, the companies would use a bond, a surety, they would bring anti-dumping products under the bond, and when the entry was liquidated and customs subsequently issued the bill, they would go bankrupt and depriving government of revenue. By the time the anti-dumping duties generally liquidate, it takes long time for them to liquidate. It takes years and years, decades, more than a decade in some cases. So this has been a huge deal. So the reaction to this was to require cash deposit. You have to pay cash, right? And as we saw in here, in this recent critical circumstances order from Russia, which we just reviewed, see the cash deposit rate, right? Cash deposit is, see here, it is so dire that they are not even entertaining the production of the production of the bond. In some cases, the situation is so important that in addition to cash, they may require an entity to post a bond. So not only the cash deposit is required, right? But additional security as a bond is also required, right? Of course, it goes on case by case basis. Here are the factors. They're all listed here, right? Single transaction bond. But nevertheless, this is an issue, right? And because this is such a huge deal. But generally speaking, right? Unless the circumstances are critical, if it's at the preliminary stage, then the bond can be okay. All right. After the preliminary order is published, you have what's known as review. So it's called usually called administrative review. And it usually conducted on annual basis. Administrative review is usually requested, so the company can request it. There is also something which can be called another type of review, a new ship review. This new ship review it relates to the new kid on the block, a new player, which would like to have a separate rate, because remember in that Russian example you saw that 750% for two entities and then 400 something percent for the rest. Well, if the new kid on the block would like to have a separate rate, then so be it. So usually, once the administrative review is complete, or if it's not complete, it automatically goes back to the information derived in preliminary order, right? Whatever margin was determined at the preliminary order stage, if administrative review is made, they can review it and change it. So again, they're looking back at the merchandise, or they can leave it without administrative review. So request must be made. If nothing, then stays at the margin level determined at the preliminary order, right? And after that review is complete, then you can have what's known as liquidation instructions. So one way, if we go back to our ADD CVD search engine, let's take out critical circumstances, and let me put a case number which I found interesting. It relates to the turbines. And here we have liquidation instructions related to that order. So we have one example of liquidation instructions would be over here. So this one you need to understand that notice of lifting of a suspension order, right? The liquidation instructions in here, there was also a litigation. So if there is a litigation such as in this one, then that can affect the liquidation too. So if there is a court case in between, it can suspend the liquidation instructions farther down, right? And the litigation takes place in the Court of International Trade first, then it goes into the Court of, if it is appealed, it can go to the Court of Appeals for the Federal Circuit. Usually, by the time it's there, years have gone by, years of, so litigation takes time. So the liquidation structures can be further postponed farther down. So if this is the case, then it has another postponing effect on whatever order is in effect. Let's see. So let's take a look at the more recent one, the wind tower. So you know those wind towers that rotate because of the wind. If they come from Vietnam, there is a duty on them, right? And the duty over here, would the liquidation instructions here would be covering this particular period, right? And this particular period, so from 2016 to 2015, see over here, except for this one, everything should be liquidated, right? So those companies have been found to be excluded from the order because they as the litigation came in, they proved to the court and to the government that their rate should be zero, which is another interesting point. So over here's how it plays out. So Customs says that Commerce, and here they talk about Department of Commerce, does not automatically conduct administrative reviews unless they have been requested, right? And so they say, okay, so because there was no request for administrative review, right, unless you are part of this litigation group, litigation entities, that you are to liquidate all entries for the for everything which was brought in from February 1st, 2015 through January 31st, 2016. So they cover 1 year period. Those guys, they're litigious entities, they're litigious companies. So we are going to suspend the liquidation instructions for those firms. But for everyone else, the entries must be liquidated. What about the liquidation rate? So in the case of the generators, they're to be liquidated as it would be in a preliminary order, right? And what would be the preliminary one? Oops, I'm sorry. Final order, right? Because there must be a final order in place. All right, so notice of final determination. Final order of determination, right? At that point, at this point, you have, as you can see, various entities, right? To bring in wind turbines from Vietnam, Vietnam-wide entity, meaning everyone, except for those guys, which later took part in litigation, is 58.49%. That would be an example. All right, going back to the outline. So with this process in mind, let's discuss. We still haven't talked about the let's throw this critical circumstances exam question out of the way and move on to the process further. So generally, anti-dumping and countervailing duties are imposed on entries of merchandise made on or after the date Secretary first imposes provisional measures, so that's preliminary order, right? However, duties may be imposed retroactively of measures that enter to up to 90 days before the imposition of provisional measures, and which of the following terms best describes the situation. So be mindful that just like with that steel bars case, Russian case, critical circumstances were found to exist, so which allowed the United States government to impose duties 90 days before the order. So critical circumstances is the buzzword here. So final order, right? So final liability. So the preliminary order, perhaps what I should be placing this is over here. Because this would be the stage, so I jump to the administrative review here. But final order would follow the preliminary order. So this is preliminary order is just kind of like a stopgap provision, and to make sure that because this investigation takes time, by the time you get to the final order, the industry may be wiped out, especially the industry where critical circumstances found to exist, right? So the idea behind the stopgap provision, the preliminary order, is to chill those imports to make sure that there is fact finding and there is an inquiry that takes you to the final order. Once the final order is in place, you go through the reviews until what's called a sunset review. When the sun sets down, the sun sets down on the anti-dumping duty every 5 years. So administrative reviews can be conducted every year. New ship reviews whenever there is a new shipper on the block, followed by liquidation instructions. And then there is a sunset review every 5 years after the final order to determine, do this, is there still a likelihood of material injury to take place if we set the sun down on this anti-dumping duty order or countervailing duty order? If they found that there is no longer dumping occurs, there is no longer a margin, or the injury will be immaterial. For example, even notwithstanding the injury, let's say that was found to be at the final order stage, the factory closed anyway, for whatever reasons. If there is no more factories left standing, then there can be no injury, right? Because there is no one to injure. The industry have been wiped out. And because the industry has been wiped out, the sun can set, because, well, there are no manufacturer entities left in place. Sunset review decides whether to keep anti-dumping or countervailing duty in place, or whether to close down, and because either material injury is no longer in place or there is no anti-dumping that is taking place. So final order followed by liquidation instructions after the review, and liquidation instructors can tell you either the new rate as a result of review for that period, or you keep the original rate as we saw over here. Let me see. So we have final review, IARF. All right, so in the case of the windows, we have the commerce review, right? So the cash deposit rates have been revised, right? And the margin is revised, right? Therefore, the cash deposit rate is revised, and it's revised favorably, right, to this entity, the CS Win Group, to the zero rate instead of that 50% rate that we saw, right? Vietnam-wide rate, 58.54%. This is the effect of reviews. They can work either up or down. And they can be countrywide or entity or focus on a single entity. And that's when customs can send liquidation instructions, and that's the time when the importer must that's the way the customs decide to keep cash, whatever was deposited, or to go against the bond if there was a bond found to be in place, right? We discussed the liquidation, how long does order remain in effect? Well, I talked about the sunset, right? Every 5 years, right? But as long as this stuff are still around, the order will remain in effect.